Happy Wednesday, guys. Today we're starting off with some gymnastics work. We're going to do three sets of 16 alternating gorilla rows, 12 weighted or body weight hollow rocks, and then 8 kip swings with body weight, or we could use a medball in between our feet. So the focus of the gymnastics today is starting to build towards kipping movements and eventually building up to kipping pull-ups or bar muscle-ups or any style of movement that involves that kip. So we've been working a lot with those isometric holds. Now we're gonna get a little more dynamic. We're gonna still work on really activating that back and then working on our hollow rocks, but maybe progressing at this time. So if you were bending your knees from before, try to see if you could straighten your legs with these hollow rocks. We're only doing 12 every round. So if you wanna make it a little more challenging, I encourage you to do that. If you usually do hollow rocks to your legs nice and straight, and your hands overhead, let's try making them weighted. So by doing that, we can grab a plate and put that plate overhead, so holding it where our hands would be, and try to do our hollow rocks from there. Then we're going 8 kip swings. So these kip swings here, we're trying to really focus on our form and technique, so being very controlled with our kip and avoiding that pendulum swing and really trying to be controlled in our hollow body and our arch positions. If you don't have a kip swing or it's the first time you're working on it, let's stick to a body weight progression, and you can even keep your feet on a box to help you out to work on that motion before you actually fully hang from the ground. There's some other options also you can do with your coach. Another thing is if you're comfortable with your kip swings and you can keep a nice controlled swing there, let's try using a med ball. So we're gonna put a med ball in between our feet. And we're gonna squeeze, and that's gonna really force us to tighten up our core and really tighten up the groin to keep the feet together and keep our kip swing nice and tight. So that's the next kind of progression to make it a little more challenging for you if you are already proficient with your kip swings. And I highly advise you to do that if you are there. If you're not, just stick to the body weight progression and really try to master that. So if you are keeping your feet together, both on the front and the back swing there, you really can get into a nice hollow body position, arch position while doing your body weight, then I would say you're ready for the med ball. But if you're not really getting to those positions, don't worry about the med ball quite yet. We don't want to add extra stress to it if your movement's not quite there yet. So three rounds of this, guys. And I forgot to mention for the gorilla rows, let's go a little bit heavier this time than usual. Really try to work on that strength in our back there and activation for the other movements to follow. Once you're done the gymnastics, guys, the workout today is an AMRAP 10, 5 dual kettlebell deadlifts, 32 kilos for the guys, 24 for ladies, then 10 ring push-ups, and then 20 sit-ups. This workout, mostly on Wednesday workouts, we want to keep a really nice high intensity there. So these movements that you choose, I want you to choose progressions that will allow you to just quickly get through them, ideally unbroken. So ring push-ups and a dual kettlebell deadlifts, you want to keep those unbroken. With the sit-ups, I want you to be moving. It'll be dependent on how strong you are and what your endurance is like in your core, but choose that progression that allow you to continuously move through the sit-ups. For the ring push-ups and the dual kettlebell deadlifts, those you can really adjust. Again, ring push-ups, if you need to, go off your knees. Or if you're not really able to keep those rings stable, let's go from the floor, or you can try using some parallettes too to kind of mimic that position of your wrists as well. You can play around with that, but whatever progressions you use today, guys, try to keep that intensity high. And again, with this, I would say try to finish around within 90 seconds to about 2 minutes. So you're looking at about 5+ rounds for this workout minimum. And again, 10 minutes here, so we want to keep a nice high intensity. Other than that, guys, hope you enjoy the gymnastics work today and you guys get more comfortable with your kip swings, or you start progressing into your med ball variation and get a good workout out. We'll see you guys today in class.